Hello students, so in the previous class we have learned about the cyanides. Okay, so now in today's lesson we will know about the isocyanides. So first of all, isocyanides has the same type of atoms like the cyanides, but here the arrangement is a little bit different. So in isocyanides, here the alkyl group is directly attached to the nitrogen. So here there will be one single bond with the alkyl group and double bond, and after that carbon. Okay, so here the carbon, it is present in the form of carbene, right, where there is the valency 2. Valency of carbon is 2 here, or also we can write it like this. It can also be written like this, capital R single bond N. If this lone pair comes at this place, then there will be one triple bond and there will be a minus charge on the carbon atom, so it will become plus. So R single bond N plus triple bond C minus. So this is the basic structural formula of isocyanides. Clear? So next we will know about the nomenclature of isocyanides. So again there will be two methods. The first one is the common method and the second one is the UPAC method. So in common method, the first example I am taking here, CH2CN. So in the common method, it is known as methyl isocyanide. Okay? Sorry, I'm sorry, extremely sorry. That will be NC. Okay, so CH3NC, that means methyl isocyanide. Or also it can be written as methyl carbyl, it will be in short form, carbyl amine. As this type of isocyanides can be obtained by carbyl amine reaction, so this is also known as methyl carbyl amine, or also it is known as aceto isonitrile. Okay, so in case of cyanides, we only use the suffix nitrile, but for isocyanides, we will use isonitrile. So these three are the common method. Okay, these are the common method. So now in UPAC method, we can write it methane. First of all, in this case, we do not need to count the total number of carbon atoms. Just there one carbon atom is there, so methane. Then isocarbonitrile. Okay, so for one carbon you have to write here methane, then iso, after that carbonitrile, because this total group we are considering in this part. So therefore, this is known as carbonitrile. Okay, methane isocarbonitrile. So this is the UPAC method. So by this way, we can also name the other types of isocyanides. Clear? Okay. So now next, we will see the preparation methods of this type of isocyanides. So the first method, number one, so we can prepare the isocyanides from the alkyl halides. Okay, so first an alkyl halide like CH3, CH2, B, Br, that means ethyl bromide plus. Now just remember, in case of the cyanides, we were taking the alcoholic solution of sodium bromide or potassium, sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide, but in this case we have to use alcoholic solution of silver cyanide, that means AgCN. Okay, AgCN you have to add here. Now this is alcoholic solution. Okay, so what will happen now? Now this reaction that will undergo SN1 type mechanism. Okay, SN1 type mechanism will take place here. So first of all, this compound, that is silver cyanide, it is totally a covalent type compound. Okay, so here Ag single bond carbon, triple bond nitrogen. So as it is a covalent bond, so this bond is not so very easy to break. So first of all, the nitrogen that has a lone pair on it, it will act as a better donating atom. Okay, so before the breaking of the bond, this nitrogen, it will use its lone pair to attack on the carbon atom. So now this part, it will be broken like this, plus plus Br minus. Now so this will undergo the SN1 mechanism. Now this nitrogen, with the help of its lone pair, it will attack on the carbon atom. So there will be the formation of CH3, CH2, single bond nitrogen, double bond carbon. Now this bond will be broken and this silver that will be added to the bromine by forming silver bromide. Okay, so for this reason we will get this isocyanide here, but in case of the cyanides, there we were using KCN or NaCN. So both the KCN and the sodium cyanide, both were ionic compounds, and that's why this bond can be broken very easily, forming the cations and the anions. And in case of this anions, the negative charge will be on the carbon atom, and that's why in the preparation of cyanides, this negatively charged carbon atom can attack easily on those carbon. Okay, but in case of silver cyanide, as it is a covalent bond, so this bond will not be easily broken. So it will be easier to make an attack through the nitrogen atom. So that's why here the bond will be directly made with the nitrogen, and after that carbon will be there. So this is the formation of alkyl isocyanide by using the alkyl bromide. I hope this is clear. Okay, now the next process. Now the next process is known as carbyl amine reaction. Okay, so from the name you can easily identify that for the preparation of isocyanide, from this process we need the help of a amine group. Okay, so first I'm taking here amine CH3CH2NH2, that is ethylamine. Okay, now you have to add here chloroform, that means CHCl3 plus alcohol, sorry, plus alkali, that is KOH. So an alkaline solution of chloroform. Okay, the alkaline solution of chloroform and that primary amine should be refluxed here to make that compound. So after reaction, the main product that will be obtained from here is isocyanide, that has the formula CH3CH2NC. Okay, isocyanide. So it has a very pungent smell or a very unpleasant smell by which we can identify that isocyanide has been formed. Okay, so this one plus the co-products will be 3K OH has to be added. So 3K plus Cl, 3K Cl plus here two hydrogens, and this hydrogen, this three hydrogen will be added with the 3 OH making three molecules of water. Okay, so after the carbylamine reaction, starting from the primary amine, okay, and the alkaline solution of chloroform, it will make the pungent smelling isocyanide, potassium chloride and the water. Okay, so this was the second method, which is known as carbylamine reaction. Okay, now the next one. Now the next one, number 3. That will be the preparation from N-alkyl formamide. First of all, formamide. Formamide means the amide that is obtained from formic acid. What is the formula of formic acid? HCOH. That means this one. This is the formula of formic acid, and whenever this hydrogen is replaced by the NH2 group, then it is known as the formamide. Okay, now here we are using N-alkyl formamide. That means again one hydrogen is replaced by an alkyl group. Clear? Now you have to add here POCl3, okay, phosphorus oxochloride, and then in the pyridine medium, okay, so POCl3 in pyridine medium, and then you have to heat this reaction. So what will happen? So from here we will get this isocyanide, that means there will be one elimination reaction will take place by removing these two hydrogen and this one oxygen, and there will be the formation of C triple bond N R plus H2O. Okay, so again there will be the formation of isocyanide, that is RNC plus water molecule will be formed from here. Okay, so by N-alkyl formamide, by using N-alkyl formamide, we can make the isocyanide. Okay, so this was the third reaction. Now, so these were all the preparations of the isocyanides. Now we will see different types of chemical reactions that isocyanides can undergo to make different types of products. Okay, so next we will see here different types of chemical reactions that are performed by isocyanides. So the first one is hydrolysis. Okay, so first you have to take here the isocyanide. I have taken here methyl isocyanide. Then it has to be hydrolyzed. It has to be hydrolyzed in presence of water and dilute HCl. Okay, so after hydrolysis, we will get here CH3 single bond NH double bond CHO. After hydrolysis, it will get this compound, and again if we hydrolyze it in the second step, then there will be the formation of primary amine from this part, CH3NH2, okay, and from here it will make the formic acid. Okay. So the hydrogen part that will be added with the nitrogen, and the OH part that will be added to the CHO group. So it will be converted. This part will be converted into the formic acid. So because of this, whenever we undergo hydrolysis of this isocyanide, due to the presence of a carbon here and due to the presence of the CHO group, we will always get only the formic acid and not any other carboxylic acid. Because of the presence of the carbon atom here, we will get only the formic acid, and this part that will be reduced here, making a primary amine. So this is the hydrolysis reaction. Okay, now the next reaction, that is reduction, complete reduction. Number two, reduction. So here we will see the complete reduction of the isocyanides. Okay, so first of all, we are taking any isocyanide here. Now already we have learned that we can use different types of reducing agents, like hydrogen in presence of nickel or platinum. Okay, we can use lithium aluminium hydride, or we can use sodium in presence of ethanol. So any type of reducing agent we can use here. Okay, so H2 in presence of platinum or nickel, okay, or lithium aluminium hydride. So after reduction, as we know, there will be the addition of hydrogen atoms. So how many hydrogen atoms will be added here? 4 hydrogen atoms. So that means 2H2. Okay, now what will be the final product? So one hydrogen atom will be added with the nitrogen, and 3 hydrogen atoms will be added with the carbon. Okay, because nitrogen can make 3 bonds, because nitrogen shows the valency 3, and that's why one hydrogen can be added to nitrogen in a stable state or stable form. So therefore one hydrogen will be added to the nitrogen, okay, and 3 hydrogens can fill the tetravalency of carbon, and that's why 3 hydrogens will be added to the carbon. So therefore this nitrogen, if you observe this one, this is attached, this has been attached with 2 carbons on both sides, therefore it is a 2 degree amine. So what is the difference between the cyanide and the isocyanide? So after complete reduction of cyanides, we are getting primary amines, right? Whenever we are using RCN, after this thing, after complete hydrolysis, we were getting this compound CH2NH2. But in case of the isocyanide, we are getting the 2-degree amine. Okay, the 2-degree amine, that is the secondary amine. So after hydrolysis, after reduction from the cyanide, we are getting here 1-degree or primary amine, and after reduction of the isocyanide, we are getting the secondary amine, the 2-degree amine. Okay, so this was the next reaction, that is the reduction reaction. And the last one, that is isomerization reaction. Isomerization means, if we are taking isocyanide first, okay, now we are hitting the isocyanide for a longer time or for a longer period. So then there will be a change in the arrangement of this isocyanide, and it will go to the more stable form, that is the cyanide form. So that is CH3CN. So this is the more stable form, and that's why whenever we are hitting isocyanide for a longer period, okay, it will be converted into the more stable cyanide form. So this process is known as isomerization. Okay, so these all are the reactions of the isocyanides. Okay, and besides this, you have to read also that what are the properties, okay, what are the physical properties of the isocyanates. Just like this isocyanates, they show a very lower boiling point than that of the cyanides because of their lower dipole moment than the cyanide. Okay, so this by this all the physical properties you have to learn, okay, from the notes, and this physical properties, chemical properties you have to learn, okay, and as well as the uses of cyanides and isocyanates along with the difference of cyanides and isocyanides. This question is also very important. Clear? So up to this in this class. So in the next video we will learn about the nitro compounds. Okay, I hope all of you have understood it well. Okay, thank you everyone for watching this video.